Hello, and welcome to this video on creating Venn diagrams. As with most data visualizations, there are plenty of software options available to create these in, but today we're going to be using Microsoft PowerPoint. Before we get into making these, let's have a glance at what we are looking to make. Basic Venn diagrams have two circles that overlap, and this depicts the characteristics unique to A and unique to B, and the comma characteristics in the area that they overlap. For example, A could be alligator, B could be bluebirds, and unique characteristics to alligators are that they are quadrupeds and reptiles. Bluebirds, on the other hand, are bipedal and can fly. However, both lay eggs, so we could put that characteristic in the middle. This is also a Venn diagram, and we can see that they can get more complicated with just adding one more circle. We can also see from this example some of the layout issues with these diagrams. It wasn't so bad with just two circles, as we had space in the middle to show the common characteristics, but we even get to three circles, the space in the middle is really diminished. Some Venn diagrams have even more than three circles, though. Now that we have a basic picture in mind of what we want to make, let's go into PowerPoint and create one. Okay, we're in Microsoft PowerPoint now, and we've got a fresh presentation to work with here, and we're going to be making a Venn diagram that has two circles on it. We're going to be comparing birds and bats. So I'm going to show you two ways to do this. There's an advantage and a disadvantage to both. We're going to start off with the SmartArt. If you go up to Insert, and in Illustrations, then there's a SmartArt button. If we go to the Relationship category, then we have a few of them here to choose from. And down at the bottom, there's a couple different kinds of Venn diagrams to choose from. Let's go with this basic Venn diagram, and we'll click OK. Okay, so it gave us three circles. We were just going to compare birds and bats, so we don't need three circles. To get rid of them, if you click on this little arrow here, then it'll expand out the text editor. And over here, you've basically just got some bullet points that you can work with. So let's go ahead and fill in our information. We have birds, go ahead and press Enter. As we can see, that gives us a fourth one, which we really don't want. So if you press Tab, then that'll indent it, and then we can put in our descriptions for birds. So birds lay eggs, they have beaks, and they have feathers. Okay, if we click on this next one here for bats, add another line, and again, press Tab. Bats have live young, they have teeth, and they have fur. Now let's get rid of this third one here. If we just click there on the bullet pointed list and click backspace, then that goes away, and now we just have two circles. So now we can see the comparison of qualities that birds have and qualities that bats have that are unique to each of those kinds of animals. As we can see from the text editor, there's not really a way to add text in between so that we can see what the common features are and add those. We're going to go to another slide and see another way to do this. Okay, let's insert a new slide then. And again, we're going to go to Insert. We're not going to do the SmartArt this time. We're going to just do Shapes, which is also under Illustrations. And there's a bunch of them to choose from. The basic ones are up here at the top, and we want a circle. If you're drawing circles like this, you can freehand it so that they're ovals. But if you press Shift, actually, then it'll help you get a perfect circle. And before we make the second one, which we want just to be exactly the same, we're going to actually change the fill. We don't want there to be a fill, so that way we can see the text. Okay, so that's a good size. It's highlighted already. If you do Control D, and that's the same as copying and pasting, it'll just make a duplicate for you. So let's make sure that we've got some space where the circles overlap. So maybe like this. Okay, and now let's add our text. Now, unlike the SmartArt, we're going to actually have to put in a text box. So if you go up to Insert Tab again, then over here there's the button for text box. Click over here and we'll type in what we had before. So birds lay eggs, have a beak, and have feathers. Now, it doesn't format it as nicely for you as it did in the SmartArt, so we'll just do something really quick here. We'll put bullet points in here so it looks a little nicer. Okay, and we want something similar over on the bat side. So again, we'll do that Control D to duplicate it, and that way we can just edit it now that it's formatted the way we want it to. So bats, not eggs, but live young, and teeth instead of beaks, and instead of feathers, they have fur. Okay, so now we've got kind of what we had in slide one. It doesn't look quite so nice. We can make it look a little bit nicer, but it takes a little bit more work. So let's do the middle bit as well. So again, we'll duplicate this and put it in the middle. Call this both. And both birds and bats have two legs. They are both vertebrates, and they are both warm-blooded. So that's basically what we want. As I said, it doesn't look quite so nice as the first one, but we can make it look nice. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Everything's aligned, it's very readable, it's not quite as colorful as the first one, but overall this communicates what we wanted to communicate. Okay, so that wraps up this video. We've covered the basics on making Venn diagrams in Microsoft PowerPoint today. The version of PowerPoint you're using might mean some of the features I showed are in different places, aren't available, or you might have other options that you didn't see on my screen. Hopefully things should be about the same though, and the Microsoft Office support website is a great resource to check out if you have questions, although you can always contact the library as well. Thanks for watching!